the black cat, le chat noir. Everyone knows this cat. It was drawn by an artist, Théophile Steinlin, as an advertising poster for the Parisian cabaret, the black cat, le chat noir. It was an incredibly pleasant place in Montmartre, with a forbidden piano in one of the rooms and audience that anyone would dream of meeting today. It was visited by the most famous people of Paris of the time. Bohemian artists, painters, musicians, composers, everyone came here. What was so special about this café, and when did the black cat appear? The Black Cat Cabaret was opened by an artist, Rodolphe Salis. He was definitely a great person, a son of a rich owner of an alcohol factory and a baron. He loved Bohemia and wanted to become an artist. He even rented a workshop in Montmartre. Then it was a poor, even rustic area with windmills and chickens and goats walking on the streets. One day his friend, a writer Émile Goudot, came to see him in his workshop and complained that their favorite private club had gone bankrupt and now the cream of the Bohemian society has no place to meet. And Salis thought, why not open such a café for creative people? And he turned out to be a brilliant businessman because he opened not an ordinary café, but the first cabaret in the world. Those days, the police forbade playing piano in public places because loud music could conceal unwanted political conversations and even conspiracies. But Salis somehow arranged a piano to be installed in one of the rooms and invited such composers as Satie, Debussy, and the café turned into a cabaret. Guests, for example, were met by a doorman dressed as a church porter. You could not only drink here and discuss anything, but also sell your painting, for example, or perform in front of the audience completely for free. Artists often paint for the drinks with their paintings, and Salis was happy to decorate the walls of his café with them. Here chanson began to sound. A few years later, the cabaret moved to a more spacious place, and there appeared a shadow place, a theater, and a salon of incoherent arts. But that's another story. And now about the cat. Salis found a black mangy cat outside his workshop. It was incredibly raggy, but how it screamed, so loud. And somehow Salis liked the cat. Probably it reminded him of the Parisian Bohemia, also a little bit shabby, but full of creative energy. Salis took the cat home and decided to name the cabaret the black cat, Le Chat Noir. The first logo with the black cat appeared on the sign. It was like that. And later, for the Shadow Place Theater, a poster appeared drawn by Théophile Steinlin with a black cat known to all of us.